Good morning. In this session, I shall be discussing about plant tissues in brief. This topic is included in the unit Plant Anatomy of the second semester. I am Shobha Rani, Assistant Professor, Government First Grade College, Chikbalampur. Plant tissue is a collection of cells performing an organized function for the plant. Each plant tissue is specialized for a unique purpose and can be combined with other tissues to create organs such as leaves, flowers, stems, and roots. A meristematic tissue consists of a group of cells which remain in continuous state of division. The permanent tissues are those in which growth has stopped either completely or for the time being. Sometimes they again become meristematic partially or wholly. The cells of these tissues may be living or dead and the thin-walled or thick-walled. The thin-walled permanent tissues are generally living whereas the thick-walled tissues may be living or dead. There are two types of permanent tissues, that is simple and complex. Simple permanent tissues are homogeneous, that is they are composed of one type of cells only, while which have similar morphological structure and perform the same function. Parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma are the examples of simple tissues. Complex tissues are heterogeneous, that is they are composed of dissimilar types of cells which have different morphological structures. Xylem and phloem are the complex tissues through which upward conduction of water and downward translocation of solutes takes place. If we look into the types of tissues, plant tissues broadly are categorized into two types, that is meristematic and permanent tissues. Apical meristems, intercalary meristem and lateral meristems are the types of meristems. Permanent tissue can be simple or complex. Parenchyma, collenchyma and sclerenchyma are types of simple permanent tissue, while xylem and phloem are the types of complex permanent tissues. Meristematic tissue consists of group of cells which remain in continuous state of division. Some of the characteristics of meristematic tissue are, they are composed of immature cells which are in state of division and growth. Usually, the intercellular spaces are not formed among these cells. The cells may be rounded, oval or polygonal in shape. They are always living and thin-walled. Each cell of the meristematic tissue possesses abundant cytoplasm and one or more nuclei. The vacuoles in the cells may be quite small or altogether absent. The meristems usually occur at the apices of all main and lateral shoots and roots, and thus their number in a single plant becomes quite large. In addition, plants bearing secondary increase in thickness possess extensive meristems, the vascular and corcambia responsible for secondary growth. We look into the classification of meristems. Various systems of classifying meristems have been proposed by various workers, which are based on the characteristics such as stage of development, position in the plant body, origin and function. Based on the stage of the development and origin, meristems are of different types. Promeristem or the primordial meristem is the region of new growth in a plant body, where the foundation of new organs or parts of the organ is initiated. Sometimes it is also called as primordial meristem, earth meristem, or embryonic meristem. This region consists of initials and their immediate derivatives. The cells of this region are isodiametric, thin-walled, vacuolate with active cytoplasm and early stages of pits. Prominent nuclei and inconspicuous intercellular spaces may be seen. The primary meristems are those that build up the primary part of the plant and consist in part of promeristem. In primary meristem, promeristem is always the earliest stage. The possession of promeristem continuously from an early embryonic origin is characteristic of primary meristem. The main primary meristems are the apices of roots, stem, leaves, and similar appendages. The secondary meristem appears later at a stage of development of an organ of the plant body. Secondary meristem always arise in primary tissues and they are always found lying lateral along the side of the stem and root. Sometimes some of the primary permanent tissues acquire the power of division and become meristematic. Secondary meristems are called so because they arise as a new meristem in the tissue which is not meristematic. The example of secondary meristem is phellogen or corcambium. It is formed from mature cells, cortical, epidermal or phloem cells. If we look into the meristems based on the position in the plant body, they are of three types, that is apical meristem, intercalary meristem and lateral meristems. Apical meristem lies at the apex of the stem and the root of the vascular plants. Very often, they are also found at the apices of the leaves. Due to the activity of these meristems, the organ increases in length. The initiation of growth takes place by one or more cells situated at the tip of the organ. The intercalary meristems are the internodal in position. In early stages, the internode is wholly or partially meristematic, but later on, some of its part become mature more rapidly than the rest, and in the internode, a definite continuous sequence of development is maintained. The intercalary meristem are found lying in between masses of permanent tissue, either at the leaf base or at the base of the internode. Such meristems are commonly found in the stem of grasses and other monocotyledonous plants. Lateral meristems are composed of such initials which divide mainly in one plane, that is periclinally, and increase the diameter of an organ. They add to the bulk of the existing tissue or gives rise to new tissues. These tissues are responsible for growth in thickness of the plant. The cambium and the corcambium are the examples of this type. Then if you look into the meristems based on the function, they are of three types, that is protoderm, procambium and ground or fundamental meristems. The protoderm is the outermost tissue which develops into epidermis. The procambium develops into primary vascular tissue. It forms isolated strands of elongated cells very near to the central region. In the cross section, each procambium appears as a small group of cells in the ground or fundamental meristem. But in longitudinal section, the cell appears to be long and pointed. The ground or the fundamental meristems develop into ground tissue and pith. The cells of this region are large, thin-walled, living and isodiametric. In later stages, They become differentiated into hypodermis, cortex, endodermis, pericycle, pith, etc. Now let us move on to the next type, that is permanent tissues. The permanent tissues are those in which growth has stopped either completely or for the time being. Sometimes they again become meristematic partially or wholly. The cells of these tissues may be living or dead and thin-walled or thick-walled. The permanent tissues may be simple or complex. A simple tissue made up of one type of cell performing a uniform or homogeneous system of cells. The common simple tissues are parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma. A complex tissue is made up of more than one type of cells working together as a unit. The complex tissue consists of parenchymatous and sclerenchymatous cells. The common examples are xylem and phloem. Now, if we look into the types of permanent tissue, they are mainly of three types: simple tissue, complex tissue, and special or secretory tissue. Simple tissues are called as homogeneous tissue. A simple tissue may be defined as a group of similar cells that perform a common function. Parenchyma, collenchyma, and sclerenchyma are the type of simple tissues. Parenchyma are composed of isodiametric living cells which may be oval or rounded. Cells have intercellular spaces. Cell wall is thin and made up of hemicellulose and cellulose. Vacuole is present and nucleus size is small. Cells have dense and living protoplasm. Cells may show meristematic activity, so these are also called as potential meristematic tissue. It is found in cortex, pith, mesophyll tissue, and endosperm, and are also associated with xylem and phloem. According to the specific function, parenchyma may be classified into different types. Parenchyma is the type of parenchyma having larger air spaces. It is found in hydrophytes and gives buoyancy to the plant. Chlorenchyma is the parenchyma with large amount of chloroplast. It is found in mesophyll of leaf and helps in photosynthesis. Prosenchyma have parenchymatous cells becoming long and tapering at both ends without intercellular space. It helps in mechanical support. Idioplasts are parenchyma that stores unwanted or ergastic substance. We look into the functions. Parenchyma mainly serves as a storage tissue. Being meristematic in nature, parenchyma is associated with regeneration, formation of adventitious roots, graft union, wound healing, etc. Parenchyma renders buoyancy, prosenchyma gives mechanical support, chlorenchyma helps in photosynthesis, and idioblast stores ergastic substances. The next type is collenchyma. Collenchyma term was coined by Sclady. It is the living mechanical dicot tissue. Cells are longer than the parenchyma cells. Cell wall is thick and made up of cellulose and pectin. Cell carries less amount of chloroplast. Due to the presence of pectin, it is the tissue with high refractive index. Intercellular spaces are absent because at the corner of cells, secondary cell wall substance develops, due to which the cell wall becomes rigid and the thick at corners. It is found in hypodermis of dicot stem and upper and lower portion of vascular bundles of Tycot leaf. On the basis of distribution of wall thickening, colenchyma can be classified into three types, that is angular colenchyma, lamellar or plate colenchyma, tubular or lacunar colenchyma. Angular colenchyma is the most common type of colenchyma where thickening occurs only at corners of the cells and sidewalls remain thin. Lamellar or plate colenchyma, here the thickenings are plate-like and occur only in the tangential walls. In tubular and lacunar colenchyma, thickenings are distributed all around the intercellular spaces, example as in malva and salvia. It provides mechanical support to the young and growing organs of the plant in form of elasticity. Colenchyma helps in photosynthesis. The next type is the sclerenchyma. Sclerenchyma are hard, rigid and dead tissue. Cell wall is very thick due to the deposition of lignin. These are of various shapes and size. It provides mechanical support as well as rigidity to the plant body. Sclerenchyma is mainly of two types, that is fiber and sclerates. Fibers are very much elongated cells with tapering or pointed ends. At maturity, it loses protoplasm and becomes dead. Presence of wider lumen at the middle is common. Wall is made up of lignin. Fibers are present in pericycle of mini dicot and secondary xylem and phloem tissue. Fiber is the longest cell in the plant. According to the position, fibers may be of two types, that is xylary fibers and extraxylary fibers. Fibers associated with the xylem is known as xylary fibers, while the fibers present in any other part of the plant except xylem is known as extraxylary fibers, as in phloem fibers, cortical fibers, perivascular fibers, etc. Fibers mainly help in the mechanical support to the plant body in form of plasticity. Commercially important fibers are hemp, flax, etc. Sclerates have extremely thick wall of lignin with narrow lumen. These are generally formed in hard part of the plant and gives rigidity. According to the different shapes and size, it can be classified into five groups. Macrosclerates or rod cells is large and rod shaped. It is formed in hard seed coat of the family Fabaceae. Brachysclerates, referred as stone cells, is small, oval or rounded. It is formed in cortex, pith and phloem. Trichosclerates, also referred as trichoblasts, is hair-like and found in epidermis. Astrosclerates or stellate type is a star-shaped cell. It is found in intercellular spaces of leaf and stem of hydrophytes. Osteosclerates is bone-shaped and found in hypodermal layers of many seeds and fruits. Now let us move on to the complex type of tissues. A group of different types of cells performing same function is known as complex tissue. It is also known as vascular tissue. It can be mainly classified into two groups, that is xylem and phloem. Xylem, the term, was introduced by Nageli. It is the main water and mineral conducting complex tissue of the plant. It is associated with phloem and form the vascular bundles. It consists of both parenchymatous as well as sclerenchymatous cells. Primary xylem is present in the primary growth of the plant body and derived from procambial cells. It is differentiated into protoxylem and metaxylem. Secondary xylem is present in the secondary plant body. It is made up of four components: tracheids, vessels, xylem fiber, and xylem parenchyma. Out of the four components, only xylem parenchyma is living and the rest of the components are dead. Tracheids are elongated, narrow, lumen cells with tapering ends. Cell wall is made up of lignin and thickening may be scleriform, annular, or reticulated or pitted. Tracheids are found in pteridophytes, gymnosperms, and angiosperms. It develops into soft wood or non-porous wood. Tracheids form a long row placed one above the other. It helps in conduction of water, provides mechanical support, and also helps in formation of wood. Vessels are elongated, broad-ended, cylindrical elements with wider lumen. They are commonly found in angiosperms. Walls of the vessels are lignified and thickenings may be annular, spiral, scleriform or reticulate. Cell wall possesses many bordered pits, but the pits are smaller than those found in tracheids. The end walls of the vessels is perforated, known as perforated plates. Vessels develop hard wood or porous wood. Vessels with narrow lumen are referred as protoxylem and wider lumen is known as metaxylem. It also helps in conduction of water, mechanical support and formation of wood. Xylem fiber is a dead sclerenchymatous cell found in xylem. They are long, narrow with thick lignified walls and tapering ends. It is of two types, fiber tracheids, tracheid with bordered pits, libriform fibers with simple pits. It helps in mechanical support. The xylem parenchyma or wood parenchyma is the only living component of the xylem. They are parenchymatous, thin-walled, oval or elongated and present in both primary and secondary xylem. It mainly helps to store starch and fats. It is responsible for the formation of medullary rays. The function of xylems are: tracheids and vessels helps in conduction of water and minerals from base to top of the plants. They also help in the formation of soft and hard wood. Xylem parenchyma stores food. Xylem fibers helps in mechanical support. Now let us move on to the next type, that is phloem. The term phloem was coined by Nageli. It is a permanent living complex tissue. It helps in translocation of organic food from leaves to various parts of the plant. It is also called as bast or leptome. On the basis of the origin, phloem is classified as primary phloem and secondary phloem. The components of phloem are sieve tubes, companion cells, phloem parenchyma, and phloem fiber. Out of four components, only phloem fiber is dead and the rest are living. Sieve tubes are elongated cylindrical tube-like living cells. Presence of thin cellulose walls and are placed end to end. They are non-nucleated at maturity, but protoplasm possesses large vacuum. In gymnosperms, sieve cells are present in place of sieve tubes. Between two sieve tubes, there are present perforated sieve plates with many sieve pores. Companion cells are elongated, narrow, thin-walled living cells associated with sieve tubes. The sieve tubes and companion cells are connected through pits. In gymnosperms, albuminous cells are present in place of companion cells. Companion cells help in transport of food along with sieve tubes. Phloem parenchyma is elongated, pointed, living, thin-walled parenchymatous cells intermixed with sieve tube elements. It is present in monocot plants. It helps in conduction and stores food. It also contains oil, starch, mucilage, and latex. Phloem fiber are dead elongated sclerenchymatous cells having lignified walls with pits. These are found both in primary and secondary phloem. It serves to provide mechanical support. The functions of phloem are: it helps in the translocation of solute from apex to base of the plant. Secondary bast fibers, jute fibers, are of economical value. Specialized tissue or the secretory tissue. Both secretion and excretion are performed by the special type of tissue called the secretory tissue. The secretory cells or tissues either may occur at certain localized areas or may be distributed throughout the plant body. The cells have denser granular cytoplasm and nucleus. On the basis of morphological and physiological characters, the secretory tissues are classified as laticiferous tissue and glandular tissue. Laticiferous tissues are the tissue which contain latex. The laticiferous tissues originates from the meristematic tissue and matures along with the other tissues. The tissue is composed of elongated, thin-walled, branched or unbranched, multinucleated living cells. They are scattered in ground tissue of all organs of the plant body. The latex is generally milky whitish in color. Sometimes it may be watery or yellowish or orange in color. The latex is an emulsified substance that contains different organic materials such as sugars, proteins, enzymes, starch, alkaloids, resins, mucilages, etc. The laticiferous tissue is found in large number of families such as Apocynaceae, Asclepiadaceae, Euphorbiaceae, etc. On the basis of the structural variation, the tissue is divided into two types, that is latex cell and latex vessel. Latex cell are long tubular branched or unbranched living cell. The young latex cell are very small and uninucleated. The cell wall are very thin and made up of cellulose. Big central vacuole is surrounded by thin film of cytoplasm. As the plant grows, these cells also elongate and the nucleus undergo several free nuclear divisions. Hence, the cell becomes synocytic. The cell do not fuse with each other as in latex vessels. Examples are: latex cells are found in Apocynaceae, Asclepiadaceae, Euphorbiaceae and Urticaceae. The latex vessels are formed by the disintegration of cross walls of the latex cells placed end to end. The cells are living and contain multinucleated protoplasm. The vessels are unbranched in the beginning, but during maturation they branch several times. Two or more vessels which are present side by side in the ground tissue fuse with each other to form a sinusitic network. Hence the latex vessels are called as articulated laticifers or compound laticifers. Examples: latex vessels are found in Compositae, Papaveraceae and Euphorbiaceae families. The functions are: laticiferous tissue stores the food material in form of starch. It absorbs and stores the water in xerophytes. It protects the plants from grazing animals by containing poisonous substances. The glandular tissues are made up of glands. The glands are well organized and specialized structures which contain some secretory or excretory products. They occur either as single cells or in groups. Glandular cells or glands may be external or internal. External glands are superficial in nature and formed on epidermis. They may occur as hydatids, glandular hairs, nectarines, and digestive glands, etc. Internal glands are confined to internal tissues. They are formed by the lysis of some of the cells or by splitting of cells at the middle lamellae. They occur as oil glands, mucilage secreting glands, etc. So this was brief description of plant tissues. Thank you.